this show is about? Well, we don't know yet.
I have absolutely no idea.
I don't know yet.
I have no fucking idea at the moment. It's about sex and intimacy. What that means, I don't really know yet. I'm really not sure. I don't really know that any of us do yet. But we're close to knowing. I get the feeling that we're like, it's about here. Yeah. That union, just becoming everything and everything else melting away.
The blindness.
Of like, just that, is it. And also your personality, like your intent, like.
Yeah, so then the idea of saying it's like sex being the same as death.
Tessa moves away from Brian. Tessa moves closer to Anna. They dance. Brian is confused. They dance.
And I think that discussion has come more into the public sphere, like, in the last year or so, but I remember for some reason this conversation jumps to mind like a year ago now, after we had the discussion about the things that went wrong when we were rehearsing for The Shed, and when Edie brought up the fact that, like, male voices versus female voices in the room, and, like, I found that, like, fucking difficult to hear. Like, at the time, I don't think I actually could hear that or take that on in any way, because it's... So I think that's another thing that's really interesting to me, is like the position of the man and being able to swallow that.
Yeah, and not even maybe having an awareness. Because I know you guys, like, that specific situation, like, it came across that you guys just had no idea that was going on. And the shock registering on all of your faces.
What would my father think? What would my mother think? She'd probably cry.
And then he thinks, fuck it. It's 1972, this is who I am. World, I am ready for you.
He takes off his makeup.
No, he doesn't.
Yes, he takes off his makeup.
He's very happy with himself. He goes out of the door.
Smears that lipstick.
Goes out of the door and lets the world see who he is.
Smears it across his face.
But why would he?
And he stays in.
No, he doesn't. He goes out. But what we're talking about, just a second. What we're talking about is...
Yeah, things kind of emerging out of the confusion, kind of intellectual confusion almost.
Yeah. Because I also think the chats we've had with Rebecca and Chloe and stuff have, like, started to, like, hone us in on what we're interested in.
Definitely.
And now it's for the theatrical voice. We're starting to have a theatrical voice.
Yeah, and it feels like we're not quite so nervous about making stuff now, that we've had those conversations that have been like, you've got an idea, and now it feels a bit more solid.
1792. Mary Wollstonecraft published a vindication for the rights of women. 1850. Campaign for improved female rights in employment and education. 1858, first British feminist periodical. Votes for Women, 1913, Emmy Davidson died under the King's Horse. 1918, women who were householders over the age of 30 got the vote. 1928, women over 21 got the vote. 1919, women, marriage was no longer a legal barrier to women working outside the home. Kinsey, Masters and Johnson, 1961, the pill, 1963, the feminine mystique, 1967, abortion became legal, 1970, Equal Pay Act, protests of Miss World, the first National Women's Liberation Conference, first wave feminism, radical feminism, socialist feminism, the female union, 1971, America, the world has opened up for women.
At least it's starting to become more about narratives and people and stories within those settings of the 70s. Still, it should still be a conversation with today. But it's about Lila's sexual learning, I don't know.
Yeah, it feels like a conversation today about sex and sexuality, but through very kind of human stories.
This is it, it's 1972, this. You are the children of the dawning of the age of Aquarius.
Contraception was key, and now you are free. Free, floating across the cosmos like some kind of groovy astronaut. Colours spurting out of your mouth like some kind of crazy dragon. Your naked body just colliding in the infinity of everything. Because this is what it means to be alive right now. Love, love, love. You. It's in your fate, so grab it. Grab it now.
She once got out of going to bed with a man by saying,
"It would take too long to undo my boots."
I cannot see these boots.
It's Friday night. And as the glitter settles from the sparkling cat who descended from space onto BBC Two, three sets of two across one shimmering city take tentative steps towards each other.
What's the show about?
Well, show's kind of about like people trying to find a connection through thought and self-realization. Anything else? Tom.